Living in divine flow. After making the decision to become entirely location independent, it became so clear to me that there are specific steps to change that all people can follow if they want it. It's not that it's new and different every time. There are specific patterns that develop that help you move forward in life to more freedom, more joy, happiness, and well-being. Knowing what to do and when to do it. A few weeks ago, I set out on my journey again, continuing this expansion of being location independent. If you're not already familiar with the term, what it generally means is I choose to be where I want to be when I want to be there and have given up having a permanent residence for the moment. There are many expansive and leading-edge coaches and entrepreneurs doing this, and they have been for some time, all since we are having the possibilities of conducting our businesses entirely online. That's not why I've chosen this. I've chosen this because I feel the freedom of being open to new possibilities, and I'm trusting in the faith that where I am being led is exactly what is going to be the highest and the best for me. Now, I wouldn't recommend this for everyone. You would want to be really in tune with your internal desires, have a well-practiced spiritual connection, and know when to make a move, and know exactly where you're going when it's time to make that move. This isn't the first time I've relocated, so I am familiar with the territory and the patterns involved. But it's not unlike any other change you want to make in your life. If you're feeling stuck somewhere, it's because there is no movement. I know it sounds so obvious and so logical, but this is basically the bottom line truth. You need movement in your life if you want any change to occur in any stuck area. When I say movement, this doesn't mean that you have to actually change locations, although sometimes that can help. What it does mean is that you have to install a new way of being in the area you feel most stuck in. Here are a few guidelines to get you started. Number one, get rid of some old habits and start installing new ones. Number two, identify what doesn't work for you anymore and investigate why it's not working. Number three, forgive, forgive, forgive. This often has to do with forgiving yourself. Number four, take a strong look at what you want instead and start visualizing and identifying all the details of what's going to work for you a whole lot better. These ways of creating change for yourself are always being supported by the universe. In fact, it's by paying attention to what you don't want that you get to identify what you do want. It's all very simple and can be created at any time you choose. I'm not saying it's always easy, although the way I'm describing it sounds like that's what I'm conveying. Sometimes it can be quite a challenge indeed, but not always. Many times it's an incredibly liberating feeling of joy that you simply can't pinpoint. What I would say is that it resembles the closest thing we have to pure freedom. What can be the hardest part, really, is making the decision that you want something better for yourself. Making that decision is really the hardest part, quite frankly. But after you have truly decided, all kinds of support seems to miraculously show up to support all your efforts. If you are feeling seriously ready to make specific changes in your life, perhaps you're feeling it too. It's time. I'm a coach and a mentor. It's what I do, and I love to do it. I love witnessing people's lives change for the better at increasingly rapid speeds. To learn more about my coaching programs and to fill out an application to consider working with me, see the link in the description. I truly hope to help you catapult into your next level of life experience. Much love and many blessings, Suzanne.